Fox News exclusive here, a government official confirming that at least a dozen email accounts handled the top secret information that they found on Hillary Clinton's server. You may remember those emails were recently deemed too damaging to national security to be released in any way, shape, or form for people to look at. Joining me now, Judge Andrew Napolitano, Fox News senior judicial analyst. Judge, good morning. Good to have you here. Reporting by Catherine Herridge on this. What have we learned?
We have learned from Catherine and our colleague Pamela Brown and their sources that Mrs. Clinton's top aides regularly received from Mrs. Clinton via her private server top secret emails. These are emails which the aides lacked the security clearance to receive. So this tells us a couple things. One, Mrs. Clinton was so reckless in the manner in which she sent out top secret emails, knowingly sending them to people who weren't authorized to receive them. We know, too, that their acceptance, discussion, and transfer of this is a felony. We know, three, that the FBI now has leverage. The Justice Department can indict her top aides and trade with them. What would they want? Testimony against Mrs. Clinton in return for a deal with them. This is the way the government works.
Point. I mean, we're talking about Cheryl Mills, Huma Abedin, Philippe Raines. All of those names have come up, Patrick Kennedy, with regard to people who were in that circle. And one of the things that strikes me is that, you know, it appears that Hillary Clinton felt like she could run her own little, you know, sidebar to the government, right? She had, and they appear to have believed that within their circle, they had a circle of trust, that they weren't worried about passing this stuff around because they've all worked together and known each other very well, and that there was an understanding that was going to be okay. But that's not okay, is it?
Well, no, it's not okay, because in the process of their exchanging top secret emails, like you and I might exchange emails about what studio I'm going to be in and when I'm going to have an interview with you, they wittingly or unwittingly, and under the law it doesn't matter, wittingly or unwittingly, exposed the nation's most important secrets to persons who would cause us ill when they get those secrets. Let me tell you what the FBI is not able to find: an email account at the State Department in Mrs. Clinton's name.
Yeah.
Mrs. Clinton used her private server for all of her governmental email. So that
she claims that was completely legal.
It is certainly not legal for her to have caused top secret information to go to this non-secure site. And who did she talk to the top secret information with, aside from her aides? The president himself. The president himself is sending her an email, and he must see up there. It doesn't say state.gov. It says Clinton.
So now the question becomes what the Department of Justice does and how much longer it's going to take for the FBI to make a conclusion from their investigation here. What do you think the time frame is?
Jim Comey, the director of the FBI, told us in October he expected a recommendation by January 15th. That's a month ago. But in fairness to him and to the FBI, they keep going down these rabbit holes and they find more things to investigate. The investigation alone about whether or not she gave favors to foreign governments who hired her husband to give speeches and contributed to the Clinton Foundation, that investigation alone has hundreds of thousands of pages of documents in it. So the FBI's goal, I believe, is to make a discrete set of recommendations at one time. They're in no rush. They're not political. Their eyes are not on the Bernie Sanders, Hillary Clinton race. Their eyes are on the national security and the criminal laws of the United States of America, which they have sworn to enforce.
So both sides, you know, feel that James Comey is a person of great integrity and that he will make the recommendation based on what his investigation finds.
I would echo that view.
What happens after that?
Well, then it's a decision for the Attorney General, Loretta Lynch. She may feel she has a conflict because of her political contributions. She may call this politically. She may call it on the straight and narrow. If she rejects a recommendation from the FBI to indict, the repercussions against Mrs. Clinton will be, in my view, as catastrophic to her political views as if her political career as if she had been indicted.
Judge, thank you.